Rituals are very important to any organization, and at the same time, rituals are very critical to an individual, maybe even a society, even a community. In the traditional African setting, there used to be rituals that would be embedded in the society, either to mark seasons or to mark transitions into life, maybe of a family or an individual or the whole community all together. In the podcast, I've been discussing something very important. I've been fighting for the saying that the fact that the principle that we need to be life coaches as parents for our children, because the education system that we have been going through no longer works or no longer serves the world that has changed or the world that is constantly changing. And today in this installment, I add one more point as to why it is critically important for you as a parent to also become the life coach of your children. Stay tuned.
Welcome to the Life Signatures Podcast with Lawrence Namale. Lawrence is a life coach, author, and keynote speaker who loves to tackle different topics on purpose, productivity, and resilience. His mission in life is to awaken all your boundless possibilities available in you. Life Signatures Podcast is dedicated to bring to reality every single person who knows that deep down in their gut, there's got to be more to life than this. And now, here is your host, Lawrence Namale.
So I'm going to say it again, and I'm going to be on record, that the system no longer works, no longer serves. In fact, the way it was packaged and the way it has been sold to serve, it is no longer working, it's no longer fulfilling that purpose anymore. Why? Because we've been told that the education system is the single most silver bullet for achievement. And we fail to understand that even as it's being touted as the silver bullet for achievement, along the way it has very many casualties. And even if you are not a casualty of the education system, you will come out at the echelons of it, you know, at the top of it, maybe with a PhD, maybe with a master's and so on. But then what do you find on the face of the earth? You find that you are, quote unquote, jobless. And you're walking around with your academic papers, you know, looking at them as if you're the most important person on the face of the earth, but you are, quote-unquote, irrelevant because there is basically nothing for you to do. That's why I go back to the traditional African setting before these education systems came. Let me tell you this, that education is not something that is a European or whatever. It is a human thing. It is the cradle of humanity to have education. It starts from the breast, being breastfed. Education starts from there. By the way, it is not a European thing, or it's an, you know, Middle Eastern thing, or it's an American thing. It is a human thing. And this education in the ancient days, it was so special because it normally geared towards having someone become a useful member of society. And in some incidences, there are some people who were earmarked for particular functions, particular titles to be able to function in them. Some were kings, some were advisors to the king, some were security people, some were workers, some were whatever it was. But every member of society was considered important, and every individual life was considered important. And they used to go through some rituals to usher in younger members of society into their own relevance in that particular society. The initiation ceremonies were not just for, you know, initiation for the sake of it. They were for transition's sake, passing the baton on to the next generation, and so on and so forth. And so the education system came, and so for some reason it has maybe replaced the initiation ceremonies that we used to do, we used to have, and people are no longer initiated. People no longer go through transitions. In other words, people no longer have mentors or coaches that will take them through an initiation. You see, in the traditional African setting, let me talk about those organizations or those societies where people used to go to go through initiation ceremonies. They had elders, teachers, elders that will guide them, that will teach them for a season of time, and then they will be given a particular task to accomplish. Once that task is accomplished, or once that daring thing is done, then they are given the full responsibility. Probably they get married and so on and so forth, but they are given a responsibility in society. They are given land or whatever it is they are given, but they were meant to function into society. Smooth transition. Come the education system of the 20th and 21st century. What happens? We sit back, we send these guys to school, we expect them to ace their papers and come back and get jobs. We don't have any transitions going on for them. Maybe we're not even manning their transitions. That responsibility has now been changed and transferred to the head teachers and to the school and to the teachers and to the class teachers. And one class teacher is serving 40 pupils. Tell me, how are they supposed to do this fundamental aspect of helping these guys to transition? And then they have this, they call it careers master. One careers master. I remember in my school, in Kakamega High School, there were 1,000 students at one point in time, but there was one guidance and counseling master, one guy, a ratio of 1 to 1,000. Pray tell me, how is that guy supposed to help people to go through transitions in life? That's why I am coming back to you, and I'm telling you that as a parent, it is high time we became life coaches for these young guys. Because the world, the way this education system of the 20th and 21st century has been structured, it no longer works. People are coming out of this with their graduate diplomas and their PhDs and their masters and so on and so forth. And they are clueless about life. No one to hold their hands and to tell them, you know, this is the stage you're supposed to do this and this and this. We assume that these things have been inculcated in the school curriculum. It is not there. It ain't there. The school curriculum is filled up with academics. It's filled up with papers, subjects that are dealing with basically the mind alone. Basically knowledge being poured into that head. Not about reasoning, not about wisdom, not about transitioning into life. So let me just do a very fast, small recap for you. We say that if you're going to be the life coach for your child, the first thing that you're going to do is to call out the purpose that God has given that girl or that boy. Call it out. And tell them from the youngest age that they're not here on the face of the earth to pay bills and to make it in life and to survive. They are here to fulfill a mission and to fulfill a purpose. They need to know that from the get-go. Because when you tell a child that, that is what they're going to look for from that young age. But when you tell a child to ace his papers so that they can get a good job, that is exactly what they're going to do. And yet we know that those jobs are no longer there. But when you tell a child to do this, they're able to find their purpose and so on, and they're able to become people of value. The second thing that we said, which was yesterday, is that you as a life coach for that child, you are going to form, mold, strengthen their self-image, their self-esteem, and their self-concept. Their identity is going to be shaped by you as a life coach, because this world is ruthless. This world is operating on the modus operandi of survival for the fittest. People are called names. Names are being thrown here and there and so on, and people are doing crazy stuff so that they can become the best. But the only thing that your child needs to do is to become the best version of themselves, and not to compare themselves with other people. You know, this person has a car, the other one has this, and this one has this big butt, may have a small one, have these good looks, and so on and so forth. The self-image, the self-concept, the self-identity is shaped by a person in authority. And if you leave this thing to the world, they are going to eat that kid up. because the world is so ruthless. So prepare them as a life coach. But today, one of the most important things that I'm going to discuss with you is that as you assume your role as a life coach in the life of your child, your responsibility is to help them manage their transitions. Life is up to transitions over and over again. And I'm not just talking about that puberty thing, the adolescent thing, and so on and so forth. That is a very crucial stage. But I'm talking about starting to see the world the way it is and asking yourself, where do I fit in this behemoth? Where do I fit in this huge universe? Where do I fit in this helter-skelter people running up and down? Where do I fit in there? Where do I find my relevance in there? And let me tell you, very many lives are lost. Very many opportunities are lost in these small margins of transitions where a child is asking themselves their relevance in life, the gifts that they have been given, the talents that they have deep inside of them go to waste because there is no one to manage and man their transitions. They're trying to grope in the dark, figure these things out all by themselves, while all along their adults, their parents in their lives, who have assumed that the school system is going to sort that out. It doesn't sort that out. As a life coach, your biggest responsibility is to help them to transition into life. Not just those functional issues of adolescence, functional issues of dating, functional issues of getting married, but also the essence, the meaning of their existence in life and the value that they are supposed to add in life. It is up to you. It is your responsibility to help them navigate that and help them explore, extrapolate their options in life, because you have been there, my friend. You know what works. At least you know what generally what works and what doesn't work. Maybe you might not be in the know of the fashion in which that child is operating at that moment in time, or in the dispensation in which that child is operating at that time, but you know what doesn't work anymore, and you can be in the sole position to help them to transition into the next dispensation in their lives. They look up to you. This world needs mentors. It needs coaches. And those, you know, a parent is not just a person who disciplines people. They steal sugar, you beat them up. They do this something bad, you beat them up, you ground them. Those guys who are in the Western world, you're grounded. That is not your sole responsibility. I think one of your biggest responsibility as a parent is to help this guy to make sense of this life. And we see very many kids suffering all over the universe, by the way, trying to make it on their own. And they have different templates that this world has given them, that, you know, to make it, you need to be driving. To make it, you need to have a hot girl or a hot guy with a mustache. You need to have how many likes on Instagram and how many likes on Facebook to be able to make it. And we see people messing up their lives because there's no one to help them to do the transition that they need to do in life. That is why you are there as a parent, to help them manage their transitions in life as a life coach. And I'm asking you to do it. We're going to continue doing this stuff. And there are very many aspects that I'm going to tackle in the podcast. But I need you to start thinking seriously about you as a parent becoming a life coach. Don't tell me that you don't know how to do this. You do. You do know how to do this. You know, because you have experience. A life coach is basically someone who already has some kind of knowledge, some kind of experience, and they are able to enable you to see options. That's why you're there in their lives. You're not there in their lives to direct and say this way, that way, cut a corner here, you know, move this. No, you are there to ask them reflective questions and to help them to see their possibilities, to see the boundless possibilities, to see the potential that they do have, and to make a decision for themselves. They need to make those decisions for themselves so that they can be able to anchor themselves in those decisions. That's why you're the life coach in their lives. And I'm going to offer you a free resource that I've curated. If you can go to lifesignatures.life/purpose to profit, There is a book I have written that is 10 strategies to help you monetize your purpose. I believe if you can read that book, you're going to get some concepts, some nuggets that are going to help you to start speaking into the life of that child even as they grow up. But until next time, think on these things, and bye-bye. A special shout out to my mentor, Jeffrey Howard of Visionary Business University, found at mastermindmentor.com, who has graciously provided me with the soundtrack and the introductory track to this podcast. Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.